I've been knocking around churches for around 45 years, so I've been to lots of different Christian events. Some of them really, really daggy, like the the old church fates and things like that, that the doilies are out. Some of them really high quality, exciting type of things with motorcycle jumps and fireworks and everything like that. I've been to church events where they have high-profile speakers, fantastic things. Down in Sydney at the Blue Mountains, we had men's conventions there with about 5,000 blokes singing in a tin shed. And if you've never been, that is an awesome thing to hear. But some of the daggiest things I've been to have actually been the best. One, I think it was called a Wings of Light concert. I don't know if anybody's old enough to remember a group from the States. Wings of Light came out. And at the time, I don't even know if I was a Christian, but I went along with a mate of mine. And he went forward at that thing and gave his life to Christ. Now, the reason that happened was because he had people who cared about him and invited him along. And even though the whole thing was a bit daggy, and I wouldn't do it that way, this mate of mine is still a follower of Jesus today and growing and leading groups in his church and everything like that. And the reason is that people there didn't see that event just as an event in itself. They didn't go along going, wow, what's in it for us to be at this fantastic Wings of Light concert? They were thinking, how can I help my friend get to know Jesus? And other events I've been at, people have gone there. What's made the event is that people have gone there with the attitude, not what am I going to get out of this, but how can I help my friends grow in Jesus? Let's invite them along to that. So as you look at the back of the forum handout, you'll see a long list of events. And if I wasn't so concerned that Phil doesn't see me as a complete dag, I would have headed this up instead of list of MPC calendar events in 2012. I would have, and you can do this if you want to be a dag, cross out events and put opportunities. Because as leaders at MPC, that's what my prayer is, that you will see these events that are coming up this year as opportunities for you perhaps, but more importantly, for those that you're leading to grow as followers of Jesus. There's just two. I'm not going to rabbit on about all these. You can see it's a pretty full calendar year. Not every one of these applies to every one of us, but they're up the back handouts for the MPC morning, for Youth Church, and for Kids Ministry. And Derek is going to have a calendar out for Lake Church and Village Church really, really shortly that he'll give out to people. So you can collect those on the way out to see things that relate to you, but have a think about how you're going to use these opportunities that are coming up this year. Don't think, oh, not another event. Think, fantastic, here's a great opportunity that I can use to grow people. There's two that I want to speak about particularly. The first coming up for Morning Church are the launch dinners on the 3rd of February and the 4th of February. The 3rd of February for the 9 a.m. congregation and the 4th of February for the 10:30 a.m. This is just a great opportunity to gather together as God's people and celebrate what God is doing at MPC and to set forward the year ahead so that people are actually on board, like we all are now, with where MPC is going and what's going to happen. So grab a flyer, familiarise yourself with these dinners, particularly if you're in morning church, and see how you can be in your growth groups, if you're a growth group leader or if you're a part of a growth group, encouraging people to start planning to be there right now. Come along as a growth group. One thing that I would love to see happen more and more is that we don't look at these events just as individuals, but we start to create caring communities in our growth groups where we think, how can we together encourage one another to be there, looking for opportunities to build others up? And that particularly relates to the second event that I want to draw everybody's attention to, and this is pretty much for everybody. Don Carson is coming to a Food for Thought dinner here on the 10th of July at MPC. He's also doing something with QTC on the 12th, a citywide event, but this, we have one of the foremost Christian theologians in the world coming here to a Food for Thought dinner. Food for Thought has a great brand. People love it. It's always been good, high quality. This year it's even going to go to a higher level. This is going to be a great opportunity, not to get to see Don Carson, but to invite friends who don't know Jesus yet to come and hear the gospel set forth plainly and clearly by a guy who really knows his stuff. We can do that as growth groups. Maybe not everybody has got that friend that's ready to come along to something like that yet, but we can all be praying in our growth groups for people that we know, and we can be supporting people in our growth groups to encourage people along. There are huge amounts of opportunities this year. This list is not to fill your life with more stuff. It's to give you great opportunities to grow followers of Jesus in 2012 at MPC. That's basically all from me. I'm going to throw the floor open to Mitch and to Derek if they wanted to talk briefly about things Lake Church and Village Church are doing.
Our calendar looks essentially the same as the morning calendar, apart from the morning events, but things like food for thought. So if you're Village Church and Lake Church, the other things which we will be having on this year are the Reason for God. We're running that twice in Term 1 and Term 3, and I think that'll be open to the morning service as well. And we'll run the leadership course in Term 2 and Term 4. So that will be in the hope that midway through the year and in preparation for 2013, we are raising up leaders for growth groups and kids biz, so it doesn't just happen at one point, but we're actually allowing for growth. So Reason for God, running twice this year. If you've got people who aren't Christians who are asking questions, that's a good point to which to bring them. Open discussion we're doing over dinner this year. The second thing is the leadership course. If you have people in mind who you think would be good to involve in leadership in MPC.
Hello, I'm Mitch, if I haven't met you before. We probably actually won't be handing out a calendar at Lake Church and Village Church because we are Generation Y and our event horizon is about 2 weeks. We like to have open discussion and get everyone involved and feel like they own the event that we planned in advance. I just want to say four things that we'll be doing at Village Church and Lake Church which are not on the calendars. Three of them are about teaching the Bible, and one of them is about getting together as a caring community. The first three are three kind of training courses. One is a course from PTC, that's right. QTC is the college I go to. PTC is a preliminary theological certificate. We're running an introduction to the Bible course in first term, and then throughout the year we're running two gospel groundwork courses later on in the year as well. One of those is on the theology of work, and the second one of those will be on doctrine. So we're offering those to people as something more. For people in our congregations especially, they're at a time of life where they often have capacity and they're interested in learning these things, so we're going to be training people up with those things. So they're three sort of training opportunities that we'll be running. The final one is our Lake Church and Village Church camp. And this year we're taking a real risk and running it in December after exams, which is either going to be an end of year celebration or an end of year, oh my gosh, it's too busy. But that's the other big thing we're doing. And they're a great event. We get together as the two congregations and it's incredibly encouraging. This year we got together and the last time we had a camp, I think there were about maybe 60 or 80 people there. It was just prior to the plant of Village Church. We had a camp in 2011, just last year. There were about between 140 and 160. And it was a great celebration of the work God's doing. So we're looking forward to that in December. There are all the events.